Dina A. Carabio.
Thank you.
It's D, not die.
Diva.
Okay, that's right.
Sorry.
It's okay.
All right. So, why are you here today?
I wanted to attend the ceremony and for my father, Dina Anton. So we came to from California. I had my son come here because I don't like to go in the freeway. So he came to join me.
Oh, good. Good. So your father fought in World War II.
Yes.
And did he come home from World War II?
Yes, he came home, but to be honest, you know, the culture back then, the girls stayed home. And the one that did most of the business that had to do with anything would be the son, which was the father. So a lot of the story is more like secondhand than I hear. And you might ask questions. And at that time, you know,
women
usually don't talk much. Only when you're called upon and ask questions. Since I was so young then, I really kind of stayed away from a lot of things.
Good. How are we on audio?
Good.
Good. Okay. Just making sure. Because there's a lot in the background. I just want to make sure we're clear. Okay, good.
It's going to be loud, but
all right.
I've got a good seat.
Okay, good. Thank you. I have to pull myself back together. So, when you did hear about what your father experienced, how young were you?
Well, let's see, I left the Philippines when I was 9, so I only stayed there. So I was quite young, as far as that goes, because I was born in 43. So there's not too much. And my father really was a man of few words. He didn't really talk about the war that much with me. I'm pretty sure he shared it with my mother, and probably with my older brother. But other than that, he was very quiet. All I remember is one story that he got buried alive. Now, how he got out, I don't know. I guess, I mean, someone must have, you know, unburied him to survive it. And I know he got shot because I saw that at the mark. But that's about it. Just all it is the town that march. I know he developed malaria. He got that too. So I don't think it was a very happy moment, so we need to talk to me.
Understandable, for sure. So what do you think this congressional medal would mean to your father if you were here today?
He's not really much for medals. It's what he believed you are is that, you know, you do things right, don't do anything wrong, and follow them. So medals, I mean, I think it means more to me because of what my father did. But I think as far as my father's concerned, the medals really, he was just a ornament kind of thing. He just did his duty culture. Also, I think my mother was more sentimental about it than anything else. But I think it would be nice that she was still alive now to actually receive it. Unfortunately, she died. That's why I came. Since I'm the eldest now at this point, so I made sure that I was available to come. So that's why I'm here. To celebrate it for him, let's put it that way.
Fantastic. It's that simple.
Very good.